experts versus testing. We put a lot of trust in experts, but if you look at history, the experts' record is average at best. Michael Jordan was cut from his high school basketball team. Heisman Trophy winners often fail to even make the NFL team, let alone be a star. How about the merger of AOL Time Warner, HP buying Compaq Computer, or the Mercedes-Chrysler mergers? According to Business Week magazine, 87% of all mergers are failures. And remember the quote by Michael Dell, a self-made billionaire that made his fortune in microcomputers? When Steve Jobs returned to Apple in 1997, Michael Dell was asked what he'd do with Apple if he were in Jobs' shoes. Dell said, "I'd shut Apple down and give the money back to the shareholders." 10 years later, Apple is the most valuable company in the world with more cash on hand than the U.S. government, and Dell is undergoing its third restructuring. These were all decisions by experts. So if you can't trust experts, what can you do? To paraphrase the 40th President of the United States, Ronald Reagan, test and verify. It's a complex world, and there are too many variables to trust experts. Worse yet, the variables in the buyer's head are often different than the variables in your head. Further, there is no need to guess. Trusting the experts is a lazy man's way out. Let your customer tell you what they're thinking. Give them two choices, and the one that wins is the direction they are thinking. With simple A/B testing, this can be a routine and scientific process. Your customer will tell you, but you have to be willing to listen.